what we do every day is kind of try and look out 5 to 10 years, what's coming down the pipeline.
We see a lot of our customers working on very big and important topics. The clean energy transition is a big one. We see quantum computing as growing methods, but also on sustainability, on sustainable food, other areas. And so materials engineering challenges are happening across the board in each one of those areas, challenges that our customers are facing and challenges that we look to help our customers with.
We also see an increasing adoption of cryo-electron microscopy in the pharmaceutical segments. And so we are also investing to answer to those needs, specifically for the pharmaceutical industry more and more.
One of the areas that our academics are exploring are moving from single particle analysis, so that's looking at a single isolated protein, to what we call tomography. And that's customers looking at native proteins in their cellular context.
So for us, it's looking at what are the big problems the world wants to solve. We've transitioned from, let's say, a component provider, a tool provider, to a solutions provider. With that launch of the Iliad system, that's when we get there.
When we were developing the Apreo ChemiSEM, we were thinking about our customer workflows and how we can simplify them. Primarily, it's a fantastic imaging tool. But secondly, it gives our customers chemical information using EDS and structural information using EBSD. And we've combined those together in one tool.
As far as the Hydra Bio goes, that got an enormous traction in the scientific community. And it's a combination of the really high resolution SEM column and our plasma FIP column that makes it so unique.
The next step is going into quantum, and this is one of the things that we would like to go to, and doing real quantum measurement in material science.
We are mostly interested in cytoskeleton, and in particular, protein called myosin, which is the thing that makes your heart beat and the things that make your muscle work.
As the experiments become more complicated, the questions we're asking are getting more ambitious. What has been really key for me, and one thing I really enjoyed, is actually having that close relationship with the R&D teams or the service engineers, really the experts who know each and every part of the tool to a very high level individually, and so that you can ask them to help you kind of, you know, really optimize your tool for these more ambitious experiments. With Thermo Fisher Scientific, we do a lot of development and really pushing the limits of what those instruments can do, and so having that relationship makes experiments possible that couldn't be otherwise done. I think what makes me excited is the sort of unlimited possibilities for where we could go in the future and what technologies we can kind of dream up and try to realize.